Hello my friends, this video is about the Ford Kuga infotainment system. You will see what Ford's newest infotainment system looks like and you will get some tips and tricks on how to set it up. Especially interesting for you might be the sound system settings. Let's move to the car and I will guide you through the Kuga operating system. So as you can see, you have some information. So you will have information about navigation as well. You have the power used by motor. Then you have the fuel level on the right side. And down you have the information about seat belts and the range on fuel only and the range on the battery, which gear is selected, the temperature, sign recognition around. And on the left side you have the speed screen and temperature, the music on the top. And the screens here, fuel economy one more time, trip computer, this trip, traffic sign recognition, electric efficiency, tire pressure, empty screen. And then I will show you how it looks like when you change the driving style or driving adjustments. So it's normal first, eco, sport, slippery, deep snow or deep sand. And then you have the EV button on the central console. So I'm pushing it and I can choose auto EV, EV now, EV later, EV charge. So you see the engine has turned on, but we don't need it. So auto EV is just fine. On the steering wheel you have adaptive cruise control, line keeping assistant, the speed limit for adaptive cruise control and also limit for the maximum speed and control for the volume, mute. Also you can reset settings here, horn signal. This is kind of backspace, so it's put you to the previous menu. Voice control, the music or pick up the phone or the next music, previous music, next music and the phone call, menu button. And also this button, menu button, is for choosing the menu. Then let me guide you through the digital driver display for driver, of course. I already told you about these buttons. They are used when you are driving. Of course, easy access for the sound system, speed limit, the top speed limit, then adjust the turn on the adaptive cruise control and this line keeping assistant and this distance to the vehicle in front of us. Then we can adjust the speed on the adaptive cruise control and we can also reset the speed. But now maybe it's a little bit functions here. So you can choose the information on your head-up display. So basically I would say what is originally there, it's all right. However, you might adjust the position, brightness or size. If you feel it's not the best way or you don't see it perfectly fine. But then, so we have this button for voice control. We have this button for previous song or the pick up the phone. Then another button to end the phone call or choose another next song. From the menu, we can choose which screen we want to consider or which options we can include in this menu. Then this is the kind of backspace. And then let's go through the menu. So comm screen, it's basically quite clean. Then we have fuel economy. So if you want to reset this fuel economy, then you keep OK for about 5 seconds. And OK, so fuel economy. Then another screen is a trip economy or trip computer. Then is this trip, how much we drove and how much we consume and how much time we spent. Traffic sign recognition and electric efficiency, tire pressure and clean screen. Okay, let me guide you to menu. So first tab is audio and you can choose, of course, radio stations from different of them. Then you have some phone functions. You can add the phone, connect to the persons if you have the shortcuts to your favorite contacts. And keep in mind, you have Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. And then you have navigation. So it's quite responsive. At the beginning, it's maybe a little bit laggy, but then it's warming up somehow. So I don't complain and It's very useful, and you have also this keyboard built into the screen, which means you can easily type whenever you need. Search, and then we can choose the address we want and location we want. Type, click on it, and just go there, start the road. The car will automatically calculate the road, and I assume the traffic. Of course, we have notification. Please be aware that you are responsible for driving. Be aware. And you see, you have the time of arrival. You can, with this button, you can zoom into your car. You can zoom out with this button, or you can push auto. Then as fast you go, then camera will zoom in or zoom out. So if you are driving slower, camera will zoom in because you possibly need some street information. And you are, if you are driving fast on the highway, then possibly you're just driving straight and you don't need to make any turns. So, all right, so that's fine. We have also some information on the digital driver display, so we shouldn't worry about this one. Let's cancel this road and continue checking the menu. We have home button. As you can see on the top, you have temperature, hour, temperature inside, temperature outside. This one, let me see. The connectivity settings. So if you kind of allow or want to have kind of vehicle connectivity, location, data, control, remote control, if you have app and Wi-Fi, you should have over-the-air updates. Okay, let's go back. So then navigation, mobile apps, connect your phone. I'm not connecting my phone because this is just test vehicle. This is very cool. I'm not sure if I showed it to you before, but we will see when the vehicle is charging or when the power is going to battery or from the battery to the motor. And we have also signed when the combustion engine is working and the power flow. And I'm just surprised why this battery is so small and is on the back seats, underneath the back seats, because originally it is in the floor of the vehicle. So I don't know, maybe they can improve it in the next update. And then maybe I can give you my point of view for the sound system. So Bang & Olufsen is very nice. I like it. Sounds very good. But I needed to tweak it a little bit. And I raise up the trebles or high sound. The trebles should go up because we have very nice tweeters around the car. So we want to listen to them. Mid-range tones, I just put a little bit down, and the bass, I put way much up to hear the bass, to feel the basses. But it's of course up to you. You can go a little bit down. But then adaptive volume is like if you're driving and want to have the sounds increased, I assume. But then surround mode, I would assume this is a very good option. And in standard, it was put to stereo. And I don't know why, but for me, surround system sounds better. And I would advise to go this way and choose surround in this menu. Okay, so that was the sound settings. We'll not go through all of them, but you can see you can set up the clock, Bluetooth, phone, some Ford connectivities, vehicle, radio, and driving assistance. Maybe driving assistant might be important. So cruise control set up to adaptive, speed limiter, intelligent, lane keeping system. This is kind of relevant. So you can choose between the mode, and as you can see, it's like a vibration on the steering wheel, or if the vehicle will help you to stay in line. I don't like this one because it's a little bit annoying. I mean, you can just turn on kind of autopilot or lane keeping assistant, but this aid is not necessary where you are just driving, but yourself, and you can have both, but this, of course, is up to you and the alert in intensity. Then of course you will decide how strong this help you want. And then other systems, safety systems, they are very important. Pre-collision assist, braking, steering, and sensitivity of alert. Traffic sign recognition, very cool, very nice. I use it, I like it, and yeah, it's cool we have it. Rear view camera, and in this vehicle you have also a front camera. Bliss system, this is very cool. It helps me, or blind spot zone. You can also have this grade assist when it's better when you have a trolley and you are going downhill. And then in a couple of functions, cross traffic alert, very helpful. To be honest, I was not careful enough, and this warned me about a driving car, so it's very nice to have. This driver alert, I am not quite sure if this is this is like a working, but maybe. And traction, of course, everyone want to have it, traction control. We don't want to have a slippery roads. So driver assistance settings, very well done by Ford, and we can move forward. General setups, how you want language inside vehicle, which language, the temperature units, measurements, how to the fuel consumption should be shown, which ISO units, and so on. You see, you have also automatic system updates. Scan for update now. Okay, so you have to have vehicle connected to the Wi-Fi to get these automatic updates. Then you can use voice control, wallet mode. Wallet mode is very helpful when for the safety against thieves. But well, it's good to have. You have some setups for display. You can change the brightness. You can change the background. I don't know if you like it. Just let me know. I think the original is the best. Brightness, of course, but I think this can be set up to auto, yes. So it will adjust to the brightness of the surroundings. And you have preview the night background. So you see it's darker to not to make your eyes tired. All right, so that was for display settings. Mobile apps, let's take a look. Okay, nothing I can use at the moment. And navigation, of course, I have shown you before. So this is basically what we have in the vehicle. The system. Here you have your radio panel to control the audio volume. This is mute. This is for controlling the settings of the audio. Then you can change the track, stop, play, and here is the very useful feature. You can change the screen setup to show the hour, day, and temperature, or you can just completely disable it. For instance, when you're driving at night, maybe you want to have this screen turn off because it's too bright, or maybe you want to clean it, then of course you can turn it off. So it's very nice feature, very cool idea. We turn it on, and the last button is the camera, front facing camera. It's also very nice to have, and you can split the view and turn it off, and of course tune the radio stations. So you see, I can turn on the camera, front camera, and then I can see where are the lines when I want to go to the charging point. Very, very convenient. And of course, parking sensor front and the back. Big thanks to Ford Sulan Moss for lending me this vehicle. Thanks to them, I could perform a real-world test and share the experience and results with you guys. In my opinion, the system is very easy to use, is easy to learn, it's very clean and intuitive. So yes, I would say it's good, it's nice. And possibility, of course, for Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, it's really good thing.
So we are back in the studio. I hope this video was useful for you. Thank you very much for watching my content on YouTube, and have a great day, my friends.